Everyone, welcome to today's video. Further to my previous uploading about new task force global talent business type visa, I received numerous inquiries about, oh Joanne, what should I do? What evidence do you need? And they asked a lot of questions in relation to this. And today I'm going to answer some of the questions that have been commonly answered. And if I answer this question to you, when listening to my questions here, my advice is correct. That's really important. So you're not going to search anywhere website and then, you know, you don't know what's going on. And you just need to hear the news from other people or believe, or other people say, Joanna said so. So this is a public resource. I upload on YouTube. It's publicly available information. Whatever you hear anything inconsistent to whatever I advise today is incorrect. Okay, so this is really important. Only I advise in public, and when you have a contact email with me or when you call me directly. So when we schedule a call, then what I provide advice is correct. So first of all, some people ask, business owners ask, first of all, startups company, they say, oh, will the department consider a startup company? Yes, the department will definitely consider a startup company, but this has to consider what type of startup company you are carrying on. So in terms of business, for example, some startup company, they not necessarily have lot of employees, right? They might just have 5 or 6, which is perfectly fine. And then they're not making profit at moment right now. But if you're a successful startup company, you have to have numbers, right? How many numbers of clients you have acquired? Even if you haven't got a lot of profit and you're not making profit at all, but you have acquired customers. You acquired A series funding, for example. You acquire some funding from early stage of funding. Then you are able to expand nationally in a very short period of time. So some startup company ask, will the department or in Australia provide funding requirement? That is not possible, really. That is not possible. So you have to proceed with the funding requirement in the commercial market, right? You have to go to secure that. Australia is not offering benefits to everybody, handing out cash to everybody. But we provide support where in a way that you're able to sustain. This is really important. If you start a company, you have to make sure upon you move yourself to Australia with the 2 or 3 of co-founders, you're able to sustain, continuing run your company and to actually acquire new customers, right? So Australian government is not supposed to handing out cash, right? This is quite the opposite. You're actually required to invest in terms of your company expansion in consideration of your current situation. So we are not handing out cash, right? Now, what we're handing out is actually support, right? You can see the task force has quite a numerous resources, numerous support from all the departments, powerful departments, right? For example, Department of Treasury, they have money, right? Of course. But in terms of that, if a startup a company, you cannot acquire any funding from the market, you're unlikely to get any support from the government. Just say as that, okay? Australia has some kind of, match funding available, of course. For someone who's Australian, settled Australian, you have run a company more than 3 years, we have some type of funding available. But this is to have demonstrated you actually have acquired other fundings from the market yourself. Because you have to demonstrate the startup itself, it's going to grow very fast, right? So the first question, will Australia provide any support? Yes. Will Australia hand out any money? That's no, that's definitely no. Second question people ask me, how big can you define a company to be big size, right? I will be considering these three factors. One, for how many clients you have acquired under that, right? How many customers you have acquired on your number, on your contact. If you have 5 million customers, even they are not, the paid customers or they are like kind of membership customer, it's good size, right? 5 million. If you have, this is one consideration, how many clients you have in your book currently have. Secondly, in terms of sales, right? It doesn't, again, I'm not saying if you're running a company that's lost money all the times, that's a good one. But our consideration will be providing that you have good turnover, sales revenue, right? Even if you have some kind of loss, it's okay. Well, we will look at what actually this determining factor for you, your business, become a very successful business, right? So this is one of the factors we will consider. One, it is that the number of customers you currently have. Second, the revenue, the sales revenue of the company. Third consideration, of course, currently how many employees, how many contractors, paid, part-time, how many workers currently under the company structure. Now, if you have a number like 200 employees, that I consider this company is relatively large, right? If you are in Hong Kong, because obviously you have to pay salary, obviously you have kind of, you know, profit you're able to sustain. Of course, third one would be the company has made a lot of substantial profit over in the past years. Now, in terms of that, we actually not give much weight on that because of the, you know, accounting issues here. Finally, what we want to say, it's really, we're not just focusing on one factor, saying, I have 200 employees, but the company lost, the last 3 years been operating in loss. So it is not just a single factor to determine whether you'll be able to meet the task force requirement. We'll consider, I am going to consider all the factors, combination of all that, whether to determine one result, whether your company, once you relocate to Australia, your company, your staff member, after you relocate to Australia, whether you make benefit to Australia. Our consideration will be good like this. It's your technology. Does your company bring technological advancement, right? This is first thing. Do you do something that we don't do here? Can you bring some technology that we don't have? That's first consideration. But it's not the one, only one consideration. First one, technological advancement. Second one, that your company will be expanding regardless where you are. This is really important because some company, because they are local companies, they only, you know, operate locally in Hong Kong. If it really restrict to the local situation, for example, retail company, right? They're gonna be very hard to adjust into the new market. And you cannot show, you cannot demonstrate in the current situation and retail business will be able to expand dramatically. This is unlikely to happen. So your company will operate in a way that without distance and space, you're able to really successfully transfer the whole team into Australia or open up a new branch in a very short period of time without massive of a change in culture, change in our company structure, right? So this is second consideration. A third consideration will be whether your team, like what you're doing, it's very, very great and being recognized in different organizations, different countries. It doesn't necessarily mean that something that you have already had, right? For example, your guys has been doing this and that, you provide service to lots of customers. Now, and then you are very recognized in the international community. People know you're doing a really great job as a startup, for example, acquire a serious funding. Now we see, oh, this is a really great expansion. You have a room to expand in Australia after you relocate to Australia. So really, for the task force consideration, we always have considered one thing, that how much you can actually bring to Australia, right? This type of visa is not asked, please come to here, we're going to hand out cash again. This is not our like consideration. If you cannot sustain, if your company will not be able to sustain after you migrate to Australia, for example, that you your accounting book, right, showing you do not have a substantial fund, after three members of team members relocate to Australia, you not cannot afford to pay that salary. According to Australian market, then this is unlikely to bring any benefits, right? Because you're gonna bring them here and these people, your employees, going to lose their jobs, right? We don't want this happening. Now, I also have another question people ask me. Often they ask me, what kind of people are who can actually come? So I have a business and I have my chief operation manager, I have my chief technical advisor. For example, my company structure, we have chief technical advisor, we have a chief operation manager, right? And this is a really cool, critical decision, critical person in our team. And this team is, they are really, you know, very major decision maker in that. I cannot run the company without them. This is really great, and they must be in Australia to run this with me when I relocate from Hong Kong to Australia. And these people will be considered provide permanent visa at the same time as me, because I cannot run the company without them, right? But if you say I'm going to hand out an accountant in my company, this is unlikely to adjust that department actually needs you, because really, the accountant in Hong Kong, maybe they have a similar system here, but it is actually easy to find accounting service in Australia after you relocate to Australia, right? It is very easy to do that. You can either hire external accounting system, or internally you can have you can give a job to a local accountant. But if you say someone who's cheap financial controller, for example, they understand the structure of the company, the numbers, figures part of that, they must come with you. It is justifiable, right? So therefore you can see that who can be considered, they have to be a senior member within or abroad, within the decision making, and then you have to have a very clear business plan what you're gonna do that. Now, I do not need to you to send out like pages of business plan, 20 pages of business, that's nonsense. We don't need to do that. Nowadays, because of the advancement of technology, we change rapidly about our strategy and business idea and the business strategy, right? And planning. So you do not need to provide a bunch of business plans. And I actually hate that. You can actually give me some kind of a few pages, what you're gonna do, where you're gonna want to relocate. Think about consideration of that, the expense part, right? If you rent an office, what you're gonna rent out office, either stay working from home first or rent out a co-worker space, and you kind of understand the kind of expense. And you need to justify, after you relocate Australia, you're able to first maintain your current client pool. Secondly, you're able to expand, and you need to tell us how you actually expand. So I actually want everybody to think big. This is a great opportunity, and to really demonstrate intention with relocating to Australia. And after we've done really successful cases, I've done really successful cases, I still have 100% approval rate for the current Global Talent Independent Visa. I have a very strong professional relationship with the department, with the skill assessing body, with all organizations. This is really because we have one single goal, and we only do one thing. Over the year, consistently, I don't sell house. People ask me about their house. I'll say, you know what? After your visa is granted, we'll provide free information where you can find your house, right? realestate.com.au is free. So I don't sell house. I don't refer you to any of my friends for getting commission. I don't sell health insurance. I don't sell car. The reason why I'm good, just one thing, just same to you. If you're my client, I know that. This is why I can showcase your file, your presentation, your profile to the department so perfectly. Because I'm like you. I do one thing over a very long period of time, consistently and persistently. I never stop until I got result for clients. That's really differentiate myself with others. Some others, they might not have a migration agent registration at all. And they might sell house at the same time. They do anything, jump without anything to do things. Just get commission here, commission there. I do this. I get result for you. So if you're my one of client, you know that. After you've dealt with me, I communicate with you directly. And I communicate with the department directly from my end. All right, so this is the second video I talk about task force. And just to answer some common questions being asked over the last 2 weeks. But in public, this is actually the first information I post in YouTube. This is actually first source information. If you heard anyone copy my information, you have to make sure they actually understand what I'm talking here. All right, thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and pop in ask any questions through our Facebook Messenger. I'll be seeing you there. Bye-bye.